Worm. This is where all the Millin takes place down here. So I'm joined by Peter, who's our expert on Millin. Now, Peter, this is absolutely huge, this stone here. Is this what was used for the milling?
Well, yes, Sam. This is a pair of millstones. There are two of them. The one I've got my foot on is called the bedstone, and that just sits on the floor. And there's this axle or shaft that comes up through the middle of it, and that goes round and round. It's driven by the gear wheels underneath, which I think we'll have a look at. And then the runner stone here is the one that's going to actually move. The two stones together weigh about the same as a car,
wow,
a family car. They're heavy. And this runner stone turns over and sits on top of the axle, and it gets driven round by the gearing.
Great, so there's lots and lots of lines in here,
is
that what helps?
These are grooves that are cut on the stones, and we've got a little model here to show you how the grooves work.
Okay.
So that's a model of the bedstone with the black lines and the grooves on it. That's the runner stone with the grooves on that, and they fit together like that. And as the top stone turns, you can see the grooves cut across each other, so it actually chops the oats as it goes through. And also it's pushing towards the outside all the time. If you look at the lines,
okay,
it's just pushing to the outside.
All the oatmeal would be moving and then would eventually drop off the side.
The oats goes into the centre, moves to the outside and it comes out.
Ooh, right,
and you'll see that over there in a minute.
Wait, so these are so huge, Peter. So how do you power these?
Well, about 2,000 years ago, people worked out you could use water power to do it. So we've got a water wheel over here. Can we go and have a look at the water wheel?
Yeah, let's
take a look. Okay, so here's the wheel down here.
Wow.
Right, and at the moment there's no water going, or very little water going. When we open the sluice and let the water onto it, the weight of the water will build up and start to turn it.
Okay.
Would you like to start it?
I'd love to have a
go.
Go
on, why not?
So I just put it down, do I?
Pull that lever down
there,
and the water will
start
to flow.
I've got the power.
There
we go.
You hear the noise of it starting up. Now look at the water here.
Here we go. So it's like a giant windmill in a sense, isn't it, really? Or it's maybe one of those things you have in a bar, like your nipples.
Yes.
Just tip the water in, there we go. Wow, here we go.
And that wheel weighs about 10 tons. That's the weight of two or three elephants.
That's crazy.
It's amazing.
It's amazing. And so that has just made enough power for everything to start working in here.
All the wheels all going round, and we've got the millstones here that are actually doing the grinding.
Wow. Can you take a look at what the millstone actually does?
Well, let's start at the top here,
okay,
because the oats comes down this chute here and goes into the hopper. So this is a hopper containing the oats. And then from there, it goes down this sloping chute down here, and it drops into the middle of the millstone through the hole that's called the eye, and it comes out at the edge. And if you look down here, you can see the oatmeal coming out around the edge, and that's the actual oatmeal that's coming out around there. And then it gets carried around by the action of the wheel to a chute that's over at the back here, and it goes down the chute to the flour sack that's underneath in the basement. I think we've got a clip of the